So frequently asked questions on master study in structural engineering program. The very first question generally students ask me is it what is the duration of the training? So the duration of this program is 7 months in total, which will include everything. Now some students ask me that can this duration be reduced? So as a company, we have designed this course very carefully and I have given all the details of this training pattern in my other video, which is Master Study in Structural Engineering video. You can go through that. If we reduce the time period, then it's very difficult for us to give you all these things which we have promised you in this training program. Now, as you all know, you all already finished 4 years of classroom training during your engineering, or some of you might have spent another 2 years in M.Tech. After sitting in classroom for 4 to 6 years, I'm sure that you don't want to sit with us for longer duration. But still, we had a challenge. We had to make you a real engineer who has working experience, who has the right attitude, the leadership qualities, the presentation and reporting skills, somebody who knows the project from start to end, somebody who is a delivery person, who is a delivery man in the company. We wanted to make you that. Now, this is a very big challenge and that's why, but at the same time, we had a challenge of not exceeding the duration. If we keep it 1 year or 2 years, most of you may not be interested to invest another 1 or 2 years because you are already sitting on a hot seat and I'm sure most of you are already looking for jobs. So very carefully we have designed this program in such a way that we have tried accommodating as much as possible within 6 to 7 months. If you're asking about reducing the duration, then it will not be possible for us to give you the kind of output that we are talking about in this master study program. And on the top of that, structures is a niche field, which we have compared with doctors. So it will definitely take time. Structural engineer's career graph goes like this. Initially, it is very slow and slowly it will pick up. But once it picks up, sky is the limit. Just like doctors, when they are in their initial phase, they have to just do intern with the higher experienced doctors. But once they learn over the period of time, sky is the limit for them. They can even start their own clinics. In the similar way, as a structural engineer, you can get your own license over the period of time. You can start your own consultancy. You can start freelancing. You can get a job in India or abroad. Or if you're already experienced and you're doing this course to upgrade your knowledge, in that case, you will definitely upgrade your knowledge to a level wherein you can get a promotion or you can get a higher level of responsibilities, designation and positions in your existing company. So please do not ask about reducing the time period. We have already accepted the challenge to accommodate so many things in just 6 to 7 months. So if you really want to build your career, you will have to invest minimum 6 to 7 fields to become expert in this niche field. Now the next question comes to me generally, what are the timings and what is the location? So the location is our Bangalore head office. You can go through our website and the address of the training center. You can just enroll for the training program and look for the batch timings on our website. The current batch timings and upcoming batch details we always update. The upcoming batch date and the batch timings are always updated on the website. So you can keep a close look on the website regarding the upcoming batches and the timings. It is generally into 2 shifts. Morning 9 to 2 and next shift from 2 to 7. You can join any one of this. It goes from Monday to Friday. Saturday, Sunday is generally a holiday if you do not have a workshop on that particular weekend. But if you want to re-attend any of the workshop with the another batches, then you are allowed to do so subject to availability of the seats in that particular batch. For example, if you have joined in the month of October and attended your first workshop on ETAB's basics and the next batch starts in next month, that is in November, and you want to re-attend the ETAB's basics workshop, then you would be allowed to do so only if the seats are available. But if the seats are available, then definitely you can re-attend any of our workshop that you wish to do so. The next common question which comes to me is, I cannot come to Bangalore for doing this course because I'm already working or I have my own commitments. How do I do this training program? Now this also has been addressed in one of my other video which talks about master study in structural engineering in part time. So in this you have to just come to Bangalore 3 days in a month. Now, this much you will have to manage, because if you want to learn something new, if you want to upgrade your knowledge, which will eventually give you returns in terms of your job position, in terms of your salary, or in terms of your knowledge, the main thing is your knowledge will be at a very different level. So if you really want to upgrade your knowledge, you will have to do this consecutively for 6 months. You will have to come to Bangalore only for 3 days, and generally it is on Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So this is how in part time you can finish the course, by attending all the workshops, and the practice sessions you can do at your home, at the comfort of your home, in online through our work progress dashboard. So this is how part timers will be accommodated for the same course. The next common question which comes to me is, what is the syllabus? If you go to the link below, you can see syllabus of each and every workshop day wise. So it will give you a complete insights about what exactly is covered during the classroom training. And if you want to know about the practice sessions, then that also week by week will be given to you in online on our dashboard. Or if you are doing it full time, then it will be given to you again on dashboards, but our engineers would be there to guide you in the classrooms. Next common question that comes to me is, some students are freshers and they are not sure if structures is for them. If that is the case, if you are not very sure, then you can just do one thing. You can call us on 9036744017 anytime on Saturday. Another common question that comes to me is, I am a diploma holder. Can I attend this program? Is this program only for BTech or MTech structures? Then nothing like that. If you have passion for structural engineering, in my previous video also I have said structures is a niche field, and you should have a lot of patience and passion for this. If you have it in you, then definitely, even if you are diploma civil, you can join this training program. You may have to spend a little more time. Maybe instead of 7 months, you can customize the training program by speaking to our team in advance and make it 12 months program or something. And definitely you can do the same training program with the same content very successfully. The next common question I get is, I have already done MTech structures, then why should I do this master study program? Now, MTech structures is something which is again giving you a theory knowledge only. And even if you got some practical knowledge, you have to ask two questions to yourself. Today, as a MTech structures, if I go for any company, whether a startup company, growing company, whether I am in position to crack the interview for a structural design engineer position, you should ask the next question, what are the skill sets that I have as far as structures is concerned? What are the different structural designing softwares in the market, and how many of those softwares you know at expert level? If you know these softwares at expert level, and if you are able to complete a project from start to end, from beginning to delivery, then definitely you do not need this training program. But if you want to gain some kind of working experience, if you feel you have done MTech and learned, but you need some kind of hands-on working experience on live projects, relevant projects, and very prestigious project, which will add value to your knowledge and to your skills. Not only this, but knowledge and value to your experience letter as well as your resume, then this is a training program for you. This will bridge the gap between the theory or the academics that you have done and the practical or the industry expectations. So that's the reason, if you have even done MTech in structures, but if you are a fresher and you want to upgrade your skills on live projects, then you should be joining this training program. The next common question that comes to me is, some students are complete freshers and they are not sure whether structures is for them. In that case, we have multiple other programs also, like Master Study in Building Information Modeling, Master Study in Project Management, or we have another program called Young Entrepreneur Program, in which you start your something on your own. If you have ideas and if you think you have those kind of leadership qualities and you want to start something on your own, then we would do a complete consultancy for you, one-to-one, and we will change your idea to revenue. So that program is Young Entrepreneur Program. Apart from this, we also have another program for those students who are not really interested in structures or even to become a site engineer or in building information modeling, but they have good communication skills. In that case, we have another program known as Master Study in Contracts Management and Tendering and Estimation. You can take up this training program, which also plays very important role in any company, because contracts management and tendering and estimation is a very important department in any company. If you do not have inclination for structures, BIM, or if you are not interested to be on the site, in that case you can consider doing this particular program on tendering and estimation. Next general question which comes to us is, students want some kind of career counseling. They are very confused when they pass out. They are not sure if civil is for me. Sometimes some freshers call and say, ma'am, I don't know anything. I have done my BTech, but I really don't know anything. I'm not able to clear the interview, but I don't even know what are the different skill sets and what are the different opportunities available for me. What are the different skill sets I have to acquire in order to get the right kind of job? And I don't even know which department is suitable for me. In that case, we have a free career counseling. You can walk into our Bangalore branch office on any of the Saturdays from morning 11 to evening 4, and we would do a counseling session for you, wherein we will analyze your personality type, we will analyze your current technical skill sets, and we will tell you that which department would be better for you. First of all, we will concentrate on giving you clarity about what are the different departments in civil engineering, what are the corresponding skill sets, and how exactly you should prepare to be in any one of these lines. Not only this, if you meet us, you can just get a score which is known as employability score. We would give you a small test to find out what is your current employability score, and this will help you to plan your career in right direction. If you cannot walk into our office, then you can also call us on the following numbers to get a counseling on phone. Not only this, if you subscribe to our YouTube channel called eConstruct Design and Build Private Limited, then in that case, we would be uploading lot of videos for civil engineers, which will give you immense knowledge about all these things. And it will help you to remove confusion from your mind. You will have clarity about the potential of civil engineering line, and you will also learn lot of technical and non-technical stuff on our YouTube channel. So you can just simply subscribe to our YouTube channel and keep knowing the latest trends and updates on civil engineering through our technical experts. The next common question that comes to me is, some candidates have experience, but they aspire to do something better. They're already working in structures, but they're not very happy with the current job because they want to do something better, some higher level of concepts or higher level of job positions they need in India, or they want to go abroad. Now, students who aspire to go to Gulf, we have a special counseling session, and the Master Study in Structural Engineering program can be customized for those who aspire to go abroad. On the very first day, we have an induction day. During the induction day, we have goal setting. During goal setting, you have to clearly mention that what is the outcome you are expecting after master study. So if you want to go abroad, you have to write, I want to go abroad. You have to be specific that which country you have to go. If you have mentioned Gulf, or if you have mentioned Canada or whatever, we will definitely tell you that what kind of codes, international codes, you should know, and what are the different requirements to go there. So in these 6 to 7 months, we will train you accordingly. That means during the practice session, those kind of projects will be given to you, which will help you to achieve your goal. Now, some people already have structures experience. They're already working in ETABS, but they have little bit knowledge and they want to gain experience on high rise. So that they can get a particular kind of job in future, or particular kind of job position, or a higher level of position as a head of structures department or something like that. In that case also, we'll customize the practice session for you. So meaning to say, in one batch, we have different students, we have fresher diploma students, we have people who have done their masters from abroad, and they have come after doing their masters from abroad in structures. We also have international students, we have students from Pan India, from BTech background, MTech background, but each student has a different goal. Some freshers just want a break initially. They just want to start in some company where their focus is not on salary, but on something that how do I get a relevant, a very good quality experience. So if you are one of them, if you are a fresher, the way you would be doing your practice session would be different. If you are already experienced and you have come and taken admission in master study, basically to upgrade your knowledge so that you can get higher level of jobs or you can go abroad eventually, then the practice sessions will be given accordingly to you. If you are somebody who is having little experience and want to start your own consultancy in future, then we will give you a practice session and some other kind of tips and tricks that how exactly you can upgrade your leadership qualities and few other qualities which are required to become an entrepreneur. So we will guide you from start to end to convert your idea into revenue by the end of the training. So in the same batch, we have different kinds of students, varied variety of students from different parts of India and abroad. But the way you get your practice session would be different if you customize the course by giving us your exact goal on the very first day during the induction. Another common question I get from freshers is, I don't know CAD. I'm not very good in CAD. So what should I do? If I join this training program directly, will I be stuck up somewhere just because I don't know CAD? So I have a solution for this. We have recently added CAD training also. For those who want some special assistance in CAD, can join little before. For example, if the batch is starting on 25th of October, you can try joining 1 week before or 2 weeks before, so that we will give you certain assignments and a crash training, which is a one-to-one training sometimes, or sometimes in the form of a small workshop or something like that. You can consider joining 1 week or 2 weeks before if you are very weak in CAD, so that we give you a crash course on CAD as well. Another common question is, what I have to bring when I come for master study? So you have to bring your laptop. What kind of laptop configuration is required has been described by our founder and MD, Mr. Sandeep, in one of the other video on our YouTube channel. You can go through that. You need a laptop, mouse and a pen drive. That's it. And you would be getting a kit, which is your book and etc., which you would be writing. It will be a book for lifetime, hence it would be a single book in which you would be writing all the data that you learned during these 6 to 7 months. So what you have to bring for this master study program is your laptop, mouse and pen drive. You don't have to bring any notes or anything. Whatever notes are to be given in soft copy or hard copy will be given from our side to you. Not only this, the software, which is an evaluation version, which is available on the websites. You can install the softwares in advance, which are educational versions or the evaluation versions available on different websites. You can just install that and come to the class. Another common question that comes to us from MTech students is, I have completed my first year. Now, final year, my college has asked me to do an internship. So can I do this course as a part of my internship, or shall I come after finishing of my MTech? So I would suggest you should try to come to us right in the final year during your third sem and fourth sem. We would be giving you an additional certification, which is an internship certification, which will serve as one of the copy in your final year thesis, MTech thesis. So you can do this training program as a part of your final year internship. In 7 months, you would be doing multiple projects. Out of that, you can choose any one project and give it in your college or in your academy as per your academic requirement. Submit any one of the project as a final year project of your MTech. So definitely MTech students can do it while pursuing MTech instead of doing it after completion of MTech, because by the time you finish your MTech, you will be in position to get a job. You will be having an MTech degree plus a master study certification, which is giving you a practical knowledge. Hence, definitely it will be a very good combination for you, and you will be already in position to get a job immediately after your MTech. So instead of waiting for MTech to complete, you would be spending another 7 months after MTech, which is not really recommended. So if your college allows you to go for internship during your final year MTech, please do come. And same thing applies for BTech or BE also. During your 8th semester, if at all in some universities they allow internships, a complete 6 months of internship, if it is allowed, you can come. If you have exams in between, like if the MTech student or BTech student is doing this training as a part of his final year internship, and if you get exams in between, you can go for the exam and come back and continue the training program with us. And you may also get 1 month extra, which you have to mention at the time of admission, so that we can give you a month's time, extra 1 month as well if required. Another common question student ask is exam or the assessment. How do I clear that? What if I don't clear it? So I would like to tell you, this is not a coaching center, some kind of institute where faculties, professors are teaching you, or we are not a BTech, MTech college. This is a company wherein we all work as a team. Our technical team would be working with you. Independently, you will work, you will learn so many things. And this training program has been designed in such a way that if you have done this properly, if you have done each and every assignment as a team, as an individual, if you have attended all the interview sessions that we conduct throughout the program, then definitely this is going to help you a lot in cracking your examination. If you have not done your practice sessions well, then you may find it difficult. But our assessment process is very simple. It is just a written test based on whatever you would have learned during your workshops and during your practice session. Second round is the practical exam, which is a practical project. Now, throughout the course, you have been doing the projects every day. You are given a project, you have to submit it, present it, do the presentation, reporting. This is an everyday cycle for you during your practice session. Hence, you don't have to worry about this round at all. This is just another day for you in eConstruct. The third round is a technical interview round. Now, this is also very easy. How? Because right from the first month of your training, there would be some sessions which are known as mass interview sessions. All the students would be sitting together and technical team would be asking the questions. But we do not point at you that you answer or you answer. Most of the time, how it will happen is a question is asked, anybody in the group, whosoever knows the answer, stands up and give the answer. If you know, you can answer. If you do not know, just write it that what was the question. At the end of the session, our technical team will tell the correct answers as well. And this preparation, it will eventually help you not only for our interview, which is a part of assessment, but also interview that you will give after finishing the training program. Because we are actually preparing you for the industry and you should be ever ready. That's the reason these interview sessions will come to you as a surprise. This doesn't come to you like a timetable that on so and so date you have your interview. These are all surprise interview sessions which you will have throughout 6 to 7 months. And once you attend these training, these interview sessions, you will be much more confident and automatically your preparation will be done for the final assessment with us, as well as we are more concerned about you clearing the interview outside when you go for your interview anywhere here in India or abroad. Hence, your preparation is done constantly throughout 6 to 7 months. But if you are not regular, if you are absent for more time, if you are not participated honestly in most of the activities given by us, then yes, examination you will not be able to clear. And if you do not clear the examination, or if you have not done the real projects with us, then the experience letter that you get may not have the projects added up as a part of that experience letter. Hence, you should come here only and only when you are very serious and passionate about starting your career as structural engineer, and if you are ready to work hard for just 6 to 7 months to make your foundation very strong for your upcoming career, then this will help you to crack not only this exam but any exam given which you will be giving outside for getting a job as a structure in the field of structural design engineering. Some students say that how do I improve upon my presentation and reporting skills? So this will also come to you as a part of everyday work, because you would be doing different programs, you would be doing different assignments and projects, and you have to submit it to our client and you have to present it. So eventually you will definitely get used to do it. Every presentation you will be having question answer session, and we will tell you what are your strengths and weaknesses that were seen during the presentation. And eventually you will definitely be constantly working on this right from first month to last month, and you will be able to do very good presentation. Now, some students ask me that I have stage fear, I can't go and do the presentation. So that's the reason the pattern has been set up like this. Tomorrow when you are going to your company, do you want to work just as a structural engineer who is just sitting on the computer and doing his own work? Or you want to be somebody who can be counted for anything and everything? So if you want to be counted as a person who is just right hand of the boss, who can even go and attend the client meetings, give the presentation to the client, do complete explanation to the client or the team, internal team, you want to be that kind of person or this kind of person? The decision is yours. If you make this decision while you are here with us, you will definitely get rid of the stage fear or anything like that. And you will excel in your every presentation that you make. The next common question is, how do I pay my fees? What are the installments available? Do I have a loan facility? So let me tell you, on our website, all the fees related details are given. There are certain discount offers that we run from time to time, wherein you can easily get a discount, some discount. So keep a watch on the website and the last date of the discount offers, so that you make the payment before the discount offer ends and get a discount. Apart from that, some people ask me that whether loan is available. We have tied up with the foundation and some other finance institutions who will give you students loan. Those numbers are also available on our website, or you can just call on the numbers given below to know about loan facilities. The next common question comes to us is about the accommodation. Most of the students come from outstation to our office and take admission for this course. People even come from abroad. Hence, we will help you in getting the nearest PG, which is a paying guest sharing accommodation, hostel or a hotel accommodation for you. You can visit our office along with your luggage. One of our team member would accompany you in our company car to show you different paying guest accommodations available at a walkable distance from our office. So do not worry about your accommodations. If you want our team to take you to different accommodation places, then just walk into office one day before the training program and you would be taken to different paying guest accommodations. You can choose whichever accommodation you want. The accommodation costs you in between 4,000 to 6,000-7,000 rupees, depending on what kind of room you are taking. If you take a four sharing, it may be 4,000 rupees. If you take single sharing, it may be 7,000 rupees, but it includes three times food as well. And the paying guest accommodation that we suggest from our side are always very near from our office. So in the lunch break, you can quickly go have lunch and come back. Apart from that, you can spend more time in the office if you stay nearby. So we recommend that you stay nearby if you have come from outstation, so that you avoid the time spent in traffic and spend more time here in our office doing quality work. Now, one of the questions, some people say that why is the fees so high? So I would tell you that we are training you not only softwares. This is not a training institute kind of an environment. This is a structural consultancy firm. We have done live projects and we have so far designed and delivered structural consultancy projects worth 700 crores. We are specialists of high-rise building designing. We also have a structural license in Mumbai. So the whole point is, you are learning from the industry experts who are already successful in this line and who are going to mentor you in such a way that within 6 to 7 months, a very strong foundation is laid for your structural engineering career. And once this foundation is set, you are definitely going to get very good benefit and returns. This is the first point is, I would say, we are the industry experts who are training you. We are not training you anything click here, click there kind of trainings. You would be getting training on ETAB's basics, advanced, SAFE, SAP 2000, CSI Bridge, RCDC, PROCON. Add-on softwares are STAD Pro and CAD. You can ask us to train on this and we'll train you on this also, like CAD and STAD Pro, which are the extras. These many softwares, we are not going to train you as a click here or click there kind of a software. We are going to give you a right acumen, how to approach the project, and that acumen through different techniques you will be getting here. This is not a classroom training where somebody will come and teach you, but you are always involved in doing something through different activities, and these activities will actually make you ready for the industry. Not only about learning softwares, but you will be doing live projects, that too varied variety of projects. You are doing projects like independent house, villa, commercial complex, high-rise structure, culvert, chimney, tank, foundation, raft, bungee jumping, or even a bridge designing project and miscellaneous detailing projects. Once you have done all these projects, nobody can call you a fresher. This is the one advantage that I can say about this training program. If you go in a company where they have requirement of designing villas, you will be already equipped to do so. If they ask you to design some international projects, then you will be able to do it, because during our training, we'll also put you through some international projects and high-rise structure projects or iconic structure projects. So we are also preparing you for the international market. Not only this, but if you are thinking that by gaining technical skill sets, you can get a job, then you are not right. But in today's world, companies expect you to be little more. You should have the technical knowledge plus the leadership skills plus the reporting presentation skills. You should be like a whole package. Whenever you complete this course, the outcome is when you go for interview, your interviewer is going to look at you as a whole package. He will come to know by looking at your beautiful portfolio, which will have all the projects you did during these 7 months. He will look at it and he will definitely feel that yes, this person is somebody who not only knows the softwares, but he has experience on very relevant, very good projects. Not only this, he will be able to see your confidence and your leadership qualities. Not only this, but he will also be able to see your presentation, your reporting skills and communication skills. And as a whole, if you are doing this project, if you are doing this training, then as a whole, you are gaining lot of things. This is not a course where you learn some softwares, you learn click here, click there and you go. This is a course where we are building your career. We are going to build your complete personality. We would be setting your goals, we would be setting your habits, and there would be different activities which are fun-filled activities. Each day in eConstruct is going to be very dynamic and each day will be very much learning day. And I'm sure that with this much of learning, once you become a complete package, we are also going to work on what kind of dress you should be wearing when you go for the interview, how you're going to present your resume or your portfolio, how you would be writing the subject line while seeking for a job, while sending a resume to the HR, how you would be writing the body of the mail or the covering letter for any HR. Not only this, we would be doing a photo shoot of yours, and a professional photos would be taken for your LinkedIn profile and for your resume or the portfolio. Apart from this, you can also opt for 1 minute video resume, which is an optional thing. It is not a compulsory for all, but if you are interested to shoot 1 minute video resume, then we will help you for that as well. So this is a complete package. So we call it as training for getting a job or job placement training for structural engineers. So this training will make you complete full-fledged real engineer. That's the reason the fees has been priced in this way. So hence this is the fee structure, and I think nowadays even the LKG, UKG and nursery children fees is 1 lakh rupees a year. So I think for you to get your dream job, for you to set your foundation in the structures line and for you to learn from the industry experts, this kind of fees is definitely going to come back to you in form of returns, and which are very, very beneficial returns that you are going to get in your career. So this is about the fee structure. The next common question comes to me that who is going to mentor me? All the workshops are conducted by our founder and MD, Mr. Sandeep. He has worked in Gulf and designed up to G+81 story structure. He is also expert in getting the project passed from HRC committee. Our company is associated with many builders and structural consultants in Pan India level. Mr. Sandeep is a successful entrepreneur running eConstruct since 2010 here in India, and he totally holds 17 plus years of experience in India and abroad. Hence, he is the person who is going to mentor you to set your career right, whether you are a fresher, a working professional or a consultant, or if you are a job seeker in abroad. So Mr. Sandeep would be conducting all these workshops personally, month by month. Apart from that, during practice sessions, our structural engineers would be with you all the time, guiding you very well to solve any of your queries related to structures. Apart from that, most of the interview sessions are conducted by Mr. Sandeep himself, and our team of structural engineers and Mr. Sandeep would be guiding and mentoring you throughout the training program. Not only this, but at the end of the training also, if we feel that you need little more extra support, then we may extend the time for students if required. The next common question comes to me regarding placements. So I have already made it clear that placement is a fruit and you have to actually nurture the plant. So throughout this 7 months of training, we are going to nurture you in such a way that we make you ready for the industry. This is our first plan for placing you. If you are technically skilled, you will definitely get placed by yourself, and all our previous batch people have got placed by themselves only. Some people are also placed by us, but most of the students who have attempted the interviews anywhere, whether it was in India or abroad, they got placed. So if you want to know about our already placed students, you can go to our YouTube channel, eConstruct Design and Build Private Limited, and see review videos of our students who are already placed and who have successfully finished the course and who got placed. So regarding placement, our first plan of placing you is making your wings strong, not making you dependent on the branch on which you are sitting. So the simple thing is, you have to be technically skilled in order to get the right kind of job. And for being technically skilled, you'll have to have passion and patience for this line and do the whole training program very seriously. If you have done the training program seriously, trust me, you don't have to ask for job to anybody, not even to us or anyone. You will get a job by yourself. Wherever you go, you'll be seen as a complete package by the interviewer, and they will definitely prefer to offer a job to you. The other things that we give in placement assistance, I have already mentioned, but I'll just tell you once again, it's the resume building assistance, because that is the first step in getting the job. Because the whole process of getting the job starts with sending the resume to the HR, and your actual competition starts in the inbox of the HR only, because you should get shortlisted there first. So the way you will write your subject line, body of the mail and your portfolio, all these factors will affect that whether you get shortlisted for the interview or not. So that is the first thing where we are going to help you. Second thing is your reporting, presentation skills. Whatever projects you will be done in a very good report. It will be with you in soft copy and hard copy. You can carry it during your interviews also. Apart from that, your skills will be at a very higher level. Next thing for getting placement always is, you should have minimum 6 to 7 months of work experience. If you say zero work experience, then getting a job would be difficult. So we are providing you experience letter also, which is for 6 to 7 months, including all projects that you did with us. So this experience letter will be one of the tools which will help you for getting your dream job. Apart from that, at the end, after you finish the examination, we are going to help you to go to certain interviews. We will refer you to certain companies wherein you can go and give the interview. So this is about the placement training. Another common question, what if I don't clear my examination? If you do not clear examination, then don't worry. This is not a race. Every student has different background in the batch. Some students are quick learners and some are slow learners. Hence, do not worry, we'll give you some extra time and we'll make sure that we train you till you become employable or till you become enough skilled. So if you do not clear the examination or something, we will give you a little more extra time, spend more time with you and find out where the shortfall is there, and we will definitely make sure that we make up for the shortfall and you come up with flying colors by the end of the training. Another common question is, what salary package can I get after completion of my training? So in this question, you have to understand one thing. You have to evaluate that what's your current level. If you are a complete fresher and you did this course, then this course serves as a very strong foundation to start your career. But you are still considered kind of fresher only, because on papers you just have 6 to 7 months experience. What I'm trying to say is, 7 months of work experience with us is equivalent to minimum 1 or 2 years of work experience. So even though you are a fresher, but you joined us as a fresher, did a 7 months course, when you go for the work, you might be considered as a fresher since you just have 7 months of work experience on papers. So the starting salary depends on the company, whether it's a consultancy or a builder's office or what. But depending on the company, you may get minimum starting package of 3.5 lakhs for a fresher. if you are already little more experienced, and if you are able to clear the interview and make the first impression in the interview very well, you may get a intermediary level job wherein the package may be 5 to 6 lakhs. If you gain little more experience, if you are starting as a fresher, you will be hired as a trainee structural engineer. In 2 to 3 years, you can expect your salary package to go up by 5 to 6 lakhs. And eventually, by the time you get 8 to 10 years of very good experience in this line, you can definitely get very good package in this line. Now again, salary package will depend on the company that is hiring you and what kind of impression and what kind of job position or responsibilities you are handling in that company. But especially for freshers, I would like to tell you, wherever you are going, whichever company you are going, if you are able to play a role of an engineer who is a complete package, or in that case, salary will not be a bar for you. So first thing you should concentrate is on getting a right kind of core technical job placement. Once you get into any company with your good performance, you can definitely get a very good package. But the rough packages of our previous batches were 3.5 to 8.5 lakhs. This is the range of package that our students got. And some of our students got placed abroad who have got more than 15 lakhs of packages also. They are placed in Dubai, Saudi, and Malaysia, Singapore, etc. So such students have got very high packages also. So it all depends on how you have done the training program, what's your current level. But one thing is guaranteed, this start will be a right start for starting your career in structures. It will be a very, very strong foundation, and this course is not the end, it's the beginning. Once you have laid the strong foundation, sky is the limit for you. Whatever you aspire, whether you want to start your own consultancy or want to work in any company, everything will definitely come true with the right kind of attitude and knowledge and skill sets. See you soon in Civil Studio. Thank you very much for watching.